Hey guys, welcome to the Chivalry Combat Fundamental video. Now, this video is going to be revolving around the use of the Maul using the Knight class, and of course you can play other ways, but as you're going to see in the video, this is simply a voiceover of gameplay with scenarios within the gameplay that go along with what I'm teaching. You will see that using the Maul is actually something that, you know, you're allowed to do, you're allowed to use the Maul, so why not use it for how overpowered it is, right? And this video will showcase to you how exactly overpowered it is, and how you can use that to your advantage. Now, Chivalry's combat system is basically reliant on you actually hitting the other player. Now, this can be done a couple different ways. May it be, you know, you using your bow and arrow, or you using, you know, your Maul in this case, to actually just kind of attack past their block, or attack them when they're not even blocking at all. But for the most part, they're going to be blocking you regardless, and then that's when you're going to have to like start swiping your mouse to move around those blocks. This clip will show you what I'm talking about. So I decide to attack this guy. He misses me with his throwing axe. I miss my first attack. He stabs me as a result. I block his swing. He tries to attack me a couple more times, which I just stay out of the way of. He blocks my attack again, gets hit with an arrow, and then I overhead swing past his actual block. Now, this is a primary part of attacking no matter what in Chivalry Medieval Warfare, and it's, you know, even if your opponent blocks, you can still hit them by swinging your weapon around and then just completely avoiding their block. In fact, this is a pretty advanced technique that even, you know, men at war can actually abuse this a lot with their swords, and you may see them spinning around and flipping upside down just so they attack through your block. And that's exactly what you see here. You know, I simply just swiped my mouse to the right a little bit, went entirely past his block, and killed him. Now, another aspect of Chivalry Medieval Warfare when it comes to combat are your teammates. Now, your teammates actually are pretty important. You can't just go around solo killing everyone, because eventually you're going to be ganged up on 3v1, and you're going to get wrecked, like, significantly. So, what you're going to need to do instead is try to survive until your teammates show up. If you're way ahead of everyone else, and then say you need to destroy a blockade, and then, you know, you're suddenly surrounded by three enemies, all you have to do is survive until hopefully a teammate comes. And then once they do, easily the tide will turn in your favor, as shown in this clip that you're watching right now. When in doubt, you can always press F to pay respect. But that's essentially all there is to it when it comes to combat and Chivalry. You just need to make sure that you hit them, and block whenever they try to attack you, and then have to be aware of the fact that they can also feint. They can also do all of these things that trick you out, and really, combat varies from opponent to opponent, because you're facing real people. So you're gonna have, you know, every single fight's gonna be a challenge. And if you use them all, 9 out of 10 times you're gonna come out on top, unless you face someone who is better than you and knows what they're doing. But hopefully, after watching this video, you're gonna be that person who knows what they're doing. Thank you so much for watching. If you did like the video, remember to subscribe, like, all that good shit. Share this video around as well, and that's really all there is to it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Go ahead and do actually play this game as well. I do recommend it. It's enjoyable. And I am Archer, and I am signing out.